Are you okay? Oh my gosh, you poor thing. How many fingers? How many fingers? How many fingers? Do you hear me?
Hey, you guys asked for more robots. We're gonna give you more robots. Introducing the Oleg robot. No, I'm just kidding. No, he is the founder of Promobot. This is Oleg Kiva Kurtsev.
Exactly.
That's pretty good, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I nailed it. Promobot, you've probably heard of them. They've been making headlines, especially here at CES, having that Tesla incident. Can you tell us about that?
Yes. A few days ago, we moved our robots on our booth. We moved 6 robots, and the last one was in the streets because step was too high and one person can't make it up. And a few moments after that, we saw that automobile Tesla pushed a robot. Robot break down and our engineer coming to him. After 50 meters of moving, Tesla passenger came to us and he said, next. I drive a car and I tried to switch autonomous mode on a Tesla. I thought that car will move around, but it didn't. Sorry, dear guys, and I didn't want to do that. Okay, we decided that it was our fault too, because the robot shouldn't be on the street, and we don't have a time for do all police stuff, and we decided to make any reports and just hug a hand and go out.
Yeah.
After that, we looked at the robot and we understood that it's a pity, but we can use it on the show. We need to bring and make a lot of repairs. But anyway, that accident was really interesting. It was the most popular hashtag message on Twitter a few days ago. And it brought a lot of people to our booth. Mm. It's good for us, but bad for our robot.
And so that's your alibi, Oleg. Now, has Elon Musk himself called to apologize at all?
It's a pity, but not. Because he building now Gigafactory in China, and he's a little bit busy. Maybe soon. We are waiting. We are waiting.
Yeah, we're, I mean, you got your phone out. We're waiting for Mr. Musk to call any time now.
Yeah.
But besides all of that, is that robot okay? Is it in intensive care?
It's a pity, but not. Maybe I'll show you later.
Okay.
We can't repair now main board of power. We can launch it. We can move arms and everything. But I hope it will arrive soon. I hope when we'll bring
it back. I hope he gets well soon too.
Yeah.
Does he have a name?
Still not, but we think that it will be a very sarcastic name, Tesla Bot.
Tesla Bot?
Yeah, it will be very sarcastic.
That's a great name. Okay. Now, if you don't know anything about Promobots, we've talked about having very intelligent robots, and we talk about IQ in robots.
Exactly.
EQ. Has anybody thought about having EQ in robots? It may be a little bit scary, but this is a leading robot assistant from Russia. And tell us a little bit about the EQ capabilities.
Yeah. That robot can speak with you about everything, recognize your face, recognize your speech, understand what did you say. He can move arms, body, show some information and the displays, and work as assistant, consultant, promoting a place with big traffic like city malls, experts, and road banks, and another. We are using neural networks in 3 directions. The first one is the face recognition system.
Mm-hmm.
He can recognize your face very accuracy, more than 80%, and that is very useful for business applications. The second one, we are using neural networks for recognizing speech.
Mm-hmm.
We need to hear what people said. We trained our neural network and artificial intelligence more than 100,000 hours by a speech in a noisy place, and that's why he can understand what did you say in a place with big noise. And the last one is a question-answer system. We are using neural network. We don't need to make it trains like chatbots or something else. We just can upload information, upload a book full of everything, and he will read the book and answer the question. It's about 10 seconds for one question. This one is a retail robot. He can read barcode, scan, and be connected to the system of data storage of goods. Last one can receive payments and can be used also in retail or in a place where you need to sell something. And yes, last one is a face recognition emotional robot. He can collect data of visitors, and the owner of a robot can receive this information.
Pushback against hiring robots. What are some ways to get around those obstacles?
Sure. People always afraid if technologies replace their jobs,
mm-hmm.
steal their jobs. But We should remember that in the 18th century, when was invented an automatically printing machine, the building where it was born, it was in London. Mm. Anyway, at this moment, in each flat, in each office, you can see a printer. And the technology is not stealing jobs, they are producing new one. Mm. And as you remember, at the beginning of 20th century, it was 6 working days. Now there is only 5 official working days. Mm. And in the future, it will be only 4, 3, and it will bring more freedom for humans. They will can imagine anything, they can will can discover anything, they can do work with their families and this type of things.
So what you're saying is robots can make humans even more efficient and productive.
Yes.
By taking care of some of the manual work, while humans can use our brains for more of the thought leadership and
yes,
a
yes.
society, to help society progress.
Yes, exactly. You're exactly right. They can improve.
So AI is a huge component. What are some ways that you think Promobot could be improved in the future?
First of all, our team will improve speech recognition system. Our robots will hear better. Face recognition systems, they will recognize the face better.
Mm-hmm.
We can improve our software. We will improve our some types of hardware.
Have you seen these robots being used in different ways depending on the country they're in?
Yeah. One of our robot in Asia used to make massage.
To make massage?
Massage. Yeah. One of our robot in Europe worked in a sex shop
okay.
And it attract new customer.
Hey,
okay,
to
it's,
each
it's
his
a future
own.
It's enough. And some of them are using like coffee bring equipment.
Okay.
And a lot of kinds because our robots have a lot of functions, and that's why owner of robot invent any application of them by SDK.
Has there been an application of one of your robots that you were surprised by? You're like, whoa, I never thought a Promobot would be there.
It's not so funny, but I was surprised when one team invent application for merchandise. Robot can see in retail, in a place and understand how much goods it is and what people should bring and send the signal. It is the first one.
Oh.
The second one, one team built application for police. We did a robot cop for one Asian country, and he can recognize the face of violators, send notification to police, police can come and check.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
And we did a robot cop, exactly a robot cop. We called him Promo Cop.
Nice. I am still concerned for Tesla, but I would like to visit him and maybe just make sure he's okay. Yeah?
Yeah.
Could we do that, Oleg?
Right now?
Right now. Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, come on.
Oh, you poor thing. That bully, that Tesla. I'm so sorry. I hope you get well soon, okay? All right. I will send positive vibes your way. I brought you some cake.